Hello and welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host, the Toy Therapist, aka Michael Grant, and today I'm looking at a Star Wars Black Series figure, and this time I'm taking a look at the Carbonized Boba Fett. When I first seen it, I was like, I'm not gonna purchase at all any more of the Carbonized figures. I'm gonna be very selective for what I'm gonna be purchasing. I haven't got the Vader, even though I kind of regretted the decision, but I did rectify by one of my bad decisions, which I'll do in my next review. So as you can see, I'm taking a look at the Boba Fett Carbonized, and this is the one figure that really sort of leapt out of me. I'm going to be very, very selective with my Carbonized figures. I'm not going to be buying all of them. I'm only going to get the ones that really sort of speak out to me. But I just love the packaging, nice shiny packaging. I absolutely adore it. And it's got the logo of the 40th anniversary of Empire Strikes Back. And you get a nice picture there of Boba Fett. This is an exclusive, so there's no number. And you're getting, there you go, not much of a bio, but it's just Carbonized Mandalorian deadly weapon armor. But yeah, absolutely love it. I just love the shine on the box as well. It really does pop. These ones I'm not going to display. I'm just going to put them back into the box and just keep them in the box. Yes, I am an opener, and I have just basically made the value of the figure go down less, but I don't care. I keep my figures. I don't really sort of get rid of them too many, except the ones I can get rid of on eBay, the ones that don't fit my collecting rules anymore. But anyway, let's do the figure review. And as you can see, I've taken Boba Fett outside of the Carbonized packaging, and this figure is really nice. It is a very well painted figure. So, but before I get to the figure, let me just go around with accessories. They haven't changed accessories one iota, which is fine with me. You're getting his Jango Fett sort of father's blaster as well. That's just like it was in the original one when they first released him back in, God, I can't remember what year now. But the one thing I will say, though, I think this is definitely painted better than the original. Really nicely painted, very well sculpted. And it's got a bit of a shine to it as well around the grip there and so on as well. So, yeah, very, very nice indeed. But the piece de resistance is Boba Fett. But before I get to that, let me just show you the backpack, which easily comes off. And I really like the finish. Really nice metallic finish, nice scuffing there. Very well done. No issues on any of that whatsoever. Would it be nice if we could turn those maybe, but hey, I don't want to ask too much from a figure. So, I do have one little problem with it, because I think they could have done it more like the Mandalorian Carbonized version of it. Okay, so some of the differences. You're getting like a metallic-y sort of cape. And as well, you're getting the suit as well. That's all done silver paint job. Don't get me wrong, it's lovely. But I would have preferred if they just done it normal. Okay, that's normal grey. Kept that normal. But the armour and the side bits, the helmet, all that sort of stuff, the gauntlets, they could have then done that in the metallic, like what they did with the Mandalorian. But that, I'm not griping at the figure too much. I just think that would have been, it would just offset the figure a bit more. Okay. But that's just my personal opinion. Okay, he's got some of his tools in his leg there, and because of the paint finish, you're not going to see these. And that's the reason why I think that this should have been the sector grey, those being carbonized, painted silver and so on, and all the other bits and pieces, like this crotch piece as well. That's normally some sort of like rope or something like that. They could have kept that the same. Okay, like I said, the detailing is really good on it. But so that doesn't go down at all, which is a shame. So you're getting a nice head movement. Okay, you get a nice arm movement all the way around. It's exactly the same figure as the last one, basically. It's just repainted. You're getting a bit of a swivel there. And you're getting a swivel there. And you're getting a bit, not much of a tilt play or swivel there. You're getting a twist there. And you're getting the old legs as well. and you're getting good knee joints. But this is the thing that I've a bit annoyed with this figure. See if you can spot it. Okay, you pay all this money to give us a really good sort of carbonized version or this new paint job, and then you just don't do the pegs. I understand that the pegs might not have the paint because it will stop them from moving, but they could have put some sort of finish just on these, just on the outside bits there. The elbow joint, that doesn't bother me at all because that's going to move. I mean, mine's got a bit of bleeding just underneath there, but I can do that scuffing, so that's fine. But they have made the paint finish really, really, really good, and I'm really impressed with the paint finish. Don't get me wrong. Like I said, it's just I just would have preferred if this was just kept normal, and that was kept normal, but all the armor bits that could have been just kept metallic-y. But as I said, that is just me there. You're getting a nice logo there, the logo he's known for. But like I said, for me at the moment, is the paint finish of the armor bits are really good. The back there, this cape is so much better. Really, it's so much better. Better material. And just seeing those knees as well. Really, really impressed with it. Overall, I'm really impressed with it. I am going to keep it in a box, like I said, because I don't want it to be sort of scuffed in any way, because the paint job on it is really that good. So I'm that impressed with it. But like I said, a couple little problems I can just see. It's just my personal preference. I'm not dissing the figure in any way. It's just personal preference. But I do like the carbonized line, and I can't wait to see what else they do. It would be nice if they did the Royal Guard for Palpatine as well. That would be really nice, especially with that helmet being done silver. Not silver, but metallic. And that would pop, but that would be nice to see that. But anyway, this is Toy Therapy signing out. Please remember to give me a like, share, subscribe. That would be fantastic. And I'll see you guys and girls next time. Bye-bye.